Hi, Vera with Autonomous Trading. One of the questions that investors might have as of today is whether the market is overvalued, the stocks are overvalued and so on, or whether there are still great opportunities to invest in the markets. We do have a trader's course, and since the very beginning, we explain in detail, to start with, which is the primary objective of investing in the markets. Having said this, and I'm going to answer to those questions, every single lesson in the course is dedicated or towards precisely this objective. Most people, they do not have an investment methodology. Most people, if you ask them which is the objective of investing in the markets, they do not know the answer, the correct answer. And even if they know it, I already explained this before, the investment methodology that they use is not, or it has not been designed towards this priority or objective. Answering to the question whether today the markets are overvalued pretty much depends on which stocks or companies we are referring to. Okay? As an example, in the past couple of weeks, we upgraded more than one stock, more than one company, to strong buy. This to say, we recommended to invest a massive long position in, for example, one of the companies that in the future I'm going to address. You are going to see a case study. In the program, the service Artificial Intelligence, where we have or discuss, obviously, the in our perspective, the best stock picks. And one of the investment strategies that I discuss in detail is precisely related to the need of rotating capital from some positions into others. That is to say, in other words, to give an example, I gave you a price target in Amazon, $1,000, okay? And Amazon is trading at $1,000, okay? Not much above $1,000, but is around $1,000. So investors, they might have the question, for example, should I remain long Amazon? So far, those that they bought Amazon on weakness, the share price always rallied towards that price target that I offered you well before the stock got to $1,000. But Amazon was a great investment opportunity on a long-term basis when we appeared to strong buy at $77. Okay, at $1,000, it is by far more difficult to move Amazon as well as Google and other stocks. Compared to the past, okay? So the key right now in 2017 is to identify stocks, okay, that no one wants, that they have been very, Wall Street has been very bearish about, where the sentiment has been very negative. You have an example also in 2017, we upgraded a stock, a company, that very few are aware of. The name is, or the former name is Restoration Hardware at $25. Precisely, no one wanted that stock at $25. Well, the fact is that today that stock is worth more than $70, okay? So, and when we upgraded, we didn't consider, to be honest, that the share price was going to be $70, okay? So, obviously, this is an investment process. Meanwhile, many people, they jumped in on the short side, you know, raised the short squeezes and so on, as well as it happened in the case of Tesla and so on. And these things, they happen later in the game, that is, in the last, when precisely the euphoric state happens, and when helping investors to maximize their profits, okay? So, this to say what? That, like I said before, I'm going to repeat myself, you can remain long a stock or a company as Amazon, because so far nothing is wrong with the Amazon, okay? Or Intuitive Surgical, or some of the stocks that I discussed here on a long-term basis, the case of Priceline and so on. But the investment strategy that we recommended in the trader's course, that is very well defined and described in detail, it has been different, okay? So we decided that it was preferable to reduce the position sizing in some of these companies and to rotate capital into companies or stocks that precisely as it happened many years ago in the case of Netflix or in the case of Amazon, the case of Google including, and many others, no one wanted, okay? So there are companies today that eventually, and I remind you the case of Nvidia, which we upgraded here to strong buy at $12.65. Well, at that time also, we didn't predict exactly when it was $12.65, that Nvidia today it will be a stock trading at $160, okay? So this is a long-term investment process. But in the case of Nvidia, which is very different compared to the case of Netflix, because in the case of Netflix, we did in fact predicted accurately that Netflix would become the best world market performer, even better than obviously the case of Intuitive Surgical or Apple. But in the case of Nvidia, the story is different because the company changed its business model throughout the history. Okay, so many years ago, Nvidia, it was not the company that it is today, or they started changing about a couple of years ago. So when we call it the bull market, and you remember that you have articles on the website of the company, on the blog, when, for example, Nvidia jumped to $47, we were there saying Nvidia is a long-term strong buy opportunity, because the business model of the company changed completely. So the metrics that they were used to be applied in the past, they are no longer valid, and therefore all the, let's say, those concepts of resistance and so on, they vanished, okay, completely. And I'm very happy or pleased that Nvidia as of today is a class A stock, okay, along with the case of Facebook and Google, Priceline, Intuitive Surgical, Netflix and so on. And this is, you know, important because you participated in the history. And by participating in the history, you don't forget then how things they are accomplished, because by participating is precisely how you, in the end, learn about the process of investing in the markets. That is not only about stocks, okay? You have to remind that investing in the markets and to be successful is all about the different financial instruments. You have stocks, you have ETFs, you have gold, you have the Forex market and so on. So you have to comprehend what is going on across different financial instruments and also the factors that can affect them, namely, the news, specific news towards a company, but also political factors and, other stuff that we address ahead of the most important moves, okay? So, this to say, and since the title of the presentation is whether the markets are overvalued, I would say that there are companies that, yes, they are overvalued, in fact, very overvalued, in the sense that they are priced in basically for perfection. If, for some reason, some of them, they miss earnings or the markets reverse, they can correct obviously significantly, so there is a very high risk of buying stocks or some of these stocks right now, but precisely for this reason, we already planned in advance, again explaining it in the trader's course when it is necessary to explain, that you should rotate capital into companies that no one wants to be there because they will want to be there in the future. That is our perspective. And our perspective is, has been working for 30 years, okay? So those companies that they collapse, they crash. I remind you, for example, a very famous case. Today you have the precisely one case study on the web, the Yandex, company that collapsed, crashed. No one wanted the Yandex basically at single digits. But obviously, well, the Russian government was not going to let the Yandex going down to zero, okay? Or the Yandex was going down to zero, okay? So these opportunities that they appear in your life, in your during your career, you have to be there, okay? Precisely when there is blood is when you are buying the most, not then after the rally, when Wall Street upgrading, is when you are then enjoying your profits and sitting down and watching and let profits run, okay? So a couple of weeks ago, I repeat, we identified here at least one company where we recommended a very massive long position since we believe that the ultimate bottom is in. Having said this, not only that case that you are going to see then in the future, as well as some that they are already public, okay? So one of the examples is precisely a company that no one wanted, again, crashed down to single digits, the case of Valiant. Everyone was bullish about Valiant, $130, you remember, the stock in fact traded to $250. Bill Ackman said the Valiant is the next Berkshire Hathaway. Well, we explained very well that that one was going to crash, to collapse, to prices that no one believed in, so it collapsed, and precisely all the way down to single digits, as it happened with the case of Freeport McMoRan, where I called the bottom at $3.69. Then after, Freeport McMoRan rallied 500%. In the case of Valiant, you have it also on the web. The only person or the company, in the end, artificial intelligence, calling a bottom in Valiant at $8.50, and precisely at $8.50 you have the video. Valiant, meanwhile, rallied more than 100%. Okay? So if you follow the guidance that is given here in real time, when to cover your short positions on a long-term basis, when to quit the short side, and then when to reverse to the long side, your risk is zero, because some of these companies eventually they are not going down to zero. There is some already some intrinsic value, and therefore so many or most they were so negative, then in the end they are going to upgrade, and there you have the example of Valiant. As of today, you have more than 100% on the long side, while before you profited from the crash in Valiant. That no one believed in that could happen, and you had myself on more than, I don't know, 50 videos and articles saying shares are going down, shares are going down, shares are going down, and every single day, every single week, every single month, Valiant, it collapsed. So it's very complex to call a bottom in a stock, that is a fact, but that is precisely our work, our job, and that is unique in the markets, okay? So I hope that I addressed your question, that today there are still good opportunities in companies that, in my perspective, although the markets, they could reverse at any time, things they can change, and they will at some point, obviously. Don't forget that we already downgraded to buy the tech sector in the US, the power shares at $143.50. And that had a significant impact. So you remember in the past weeks, the ETF fell considerable. So that had an impact in some of the leading companies in the world, including Apple and so on. Meanwhile, you had a bounce or a rally that we already expected it to happen. But the most important is that these things that we expect to happen to be explained ahead of it happens, okay? So the pivots, they were identified in real time, and you have the lessons recorded live in the trader's course, and that is the most important, because you have the instructions in the end with regards to how to invest in the markets, the position sizing, when to take profits on the short side, on the long side. This also explains the stock ratings that you had, for example, in Nvidia, when the shares, they rallied to $168 and then they plunged to $140. So there was a $28 plunge in Nvidia, a very important one. Like I said, today you had $163 in Nvidia, but buying on weakness, it is always important, and also to take profits when it is necessary, okay? If you didn't take profits, for example, in Tesla, when my colleague told you to do so, $382 and a half, that was in fact my colleague that was the most bullish here in the team about Tesla, well, then the share price collapsed, you know, $80, okay? $80 is a lot of money, I would say, okay? So today, you know, per share. So these things, they can be done with 100% accuracy. They are very complex, but in the end, like I explained in a previous video and videos, you have always to opt in and to make your own decisions, buy stocks that they are less risky compared to others, and you have to decide where you want to place or utilize your capital, okay? So for example, you had me here saying that it was preferable to invest in companies as Alibaba. Alibaba today is a company at 52-week highs, or the case of Nvidia compared to Tesla, all right? And I already said this a couple of months ago, and it is proven, past 2 months, it is proven, as well as I told you also to sell and to go short Snapchat. That meanwhile collapsed, it crashed because there was no other alternative or option with regards to Snapchat, okay? Was not going to $31 with massive short positions here and a junk rating. It was going to crash, correct? So all these things, they were planned in advance, precisely, always having in mind the primary objective of investing in the markets, which you have in the trader's course, all right? So I hope that I've been clear or transparent with regards to, you know, what really matters, what it is necessary, whether today the markets are overvalued or, you know, or not. In the end, this is a market, a bit about stock picking at right now, okay? So be very careful buying shares of companies after the rallies, because things, they can change. If you want to buy or to invest, always, always after the crash, as we, for example, did just a couple of weeks ago, or less, in fact, in a company, okay? So that you have a stock pick if you want to, for those that subscribe to the Artificial Intelligence program, all right? And by the way, I invite you also to listen to the interview tomorrow. Thank you. Bye.